So here is the honeycomb lock screen, same as was in the preview port. Slide that up and out. Got a low battery, it's the low battery message. Galaxy Tab won't focus, but it's just the same standard error message. Alright, you got your app drawer, which in portrait is still kind of screwed up. So to fix that, if you go to camera, launch the camera, which of course doesn't work, but if you launch that and back out, there you go, landscape. As you can see, it's kind of slow, but here's the new notification panel. See if I can find out how to bring the toggles up. They have those. It's kind of like how the Galaxy phones have the little toggles. They have that too, on Honeycomb. I haven't played with it enough yet to know how to pull it up right away, but there's a way to do that, which is kind of cool. See, can I close the app drawer? Oh, there we go. Yeah, like I said, it's kind of laggy. Okay, new search force close. All right. So back on the home screen. Let's see, try one more time to bring those toggles up. Not frozen. Oh, there we go. Alright. Well, they should be right about here. I got them to work earlier. I can't get them to come up now, though. But as you see, that's also, you can't really tell. But that right there, it's working data. So if you go up to this phone is unactivated right now, so I don't have any internet connection on it, so I can't show you guys what the, here we go, just popped up for a second there, if you caught it. I don't know, you can play around with that, see if you can get it to work. The new browser, I don't have any data, so I can't, actually show you how surfing works, but you can see what it looks like. Finger in the way. It just says I can't load because I don't have a connection, which I know that. Alright, so here's a couple different tabs you can open up. I like that. Back button up here. That's full keypad, which is kind of cool. I like the new keypad with the tab button. It's pretty nice. Some bookmarks. That's cool. Oh, and if you see, I'm using the soft key buttons just because I'm used to them. But actually, what they have down there is the new virtual buttons. Home, or back, home, and I believe that's menu. Alright, let's open up music because I know everybody wants to see it. Oh, damn. I have not fixed SD card mounting. Remember, that was kind of a pain on the Gingerbread port. Probably get around to it eventually. Let's see what the new clock looks like. New font. For those who asked why I haven't pulled this font out for OMFGB, if you see right there, there's a light colors. And right there, that's kind of darker. And same on the 8s. The outside are darker or lighter than the dark. Lighter than the tops and bottoms. It's actually two fonts overlaid on top of each other, which kind of sucks. It means I can't really pull them out. This is the new alarm screen. It's pretty basic. I just like the new menu UI. Let's see, messaging. Yeah, it's still white. I don't know why they chose to do that. Should definitely have a black background. Kind of makes everything look a little better. Calculator. Nothing new there. Contacts. It just says standard things. Create a new contact, sign in, and import. Oh, that's cool. I don't think they had that in the other one. You can import contacts now. Gallery. Probably won't work because I have no. Yeah. All right. Let's show you some settings. About phone. I'll get some screenshots of this later so I can show you all. It's model numbers SDK. Android version is 3.0. I'm using Slayer's kernel. Ooh, that's kind of nice. If you see that glow, it's kind of nice. I kind of like how it bubbles up in the bottom. The build number is SDK ENG 3.0 Honeycomb, and there's the test key numbers, which none of you guys care about. Let's see. Just clicking around on the new. Ooh. Not sure which settings those were, but one of them four is closed. Oh, it was storage, I'm sure. Sound doesn't work because we don't have audio drivers, not because there's a an app that we can push to it. We have no audio drivers, that's not gonna work. Does it come with any ringtones anyways? No, it doesn't. Screen. Oh, and the de I didn't show you guys that. Dedicated, let's see, how can I get back? Take me home. I kind of locked up on you. Sorry. Oh, that's cool. That actually is not the menu button. That is brings up recent apps. This little button right down there brings up the recent apps menu. I seem to be stuck on this page. I don't know if that's because it's lagging really bad and it's just stuck, or if that's something I've done. Okay, well, there we go. So if you get stuck on anything, just hit the search button and that'll bring you back. All right, let's hit menu. Menu doesn't do anything. There's a little plus button though. You can do that. Show you the new clock. Drop that up there. There's a new email widget, which I showed you guys in the first video, which I really like. I think the email widget was very cool. Still no, there's still no messaging widget, which I don't understand why they don't have that yet. Music widget, let's see what that looks like too. I'll show you the bookmarks just because. Hit that and back all the way out. Okay, same music widget, kind of lacking, but all right. Is that? It's kind of cool. I like the new email widget. That's a very cool idea. I think that's about it. I'll be porting this to other various devices. Evo comes up next. I'll probably do the Desire HD again. Contact me on Twitter or on my site if you want to request a port. Thanks for watching.